Alright, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Big Mooney and we're back on the world of Fallout. Here we're in the Commonwealth, sitting on our throne, observing our kingdom. Our kingdom is small for now, and it's a bit of a shithole, but we'll get there eventually. And that's kind of where we're going to be going today. We need to get some supplies, build up our fortress, and then we can start expanding across the wasteland. Because of course, last week I asked the masses what you think One Bomb McGraw's aim should be. And of course, a whopping 68% of you decided it was time for world domination. So world domination's what it's gonna be. But it's gonna be baby steps. It's gonna take a while. So let's get the fuck out there and let's get some stuff done. But first, One Bomb McGraw is hungry. Harry, where is that useless shower of shite?
Excuse me.
I'm glad you
decided to come with us. I should have listened to Mama Murphy all along. Pretty nice place she's found for us. I think we could settle down here. Make it a place to call home. What do you think?
I think it's my fucking home, son.
And Nibdi invited you up here.
Garden plots over there, some snug shelters. Hell, maybe even electricity.
Mate, I'm gonna turn this place into an absolute death zone. No one's gonna think it's snug when I'm finished with this place. Yeah, I'm bored with this conversation, Preston. Could you just, like, tell me on the map where it is I need to go? Yeah, here we go. Here it is.
I've had word from a settlement asking for help.
Oh, of course.
What do you plan on doing about the jet problem in our community?
How about the settlement problem? Another settlement needs our help. I'll mark it on your map.
Alright, looks like we've got two levels up to do. So what should we go for? Oh, and by the way, in case some of you were wondering, this is what my build looks like. It wasn't made to be good. I just thought I would go for whatever One Bomb McGraw should have. And that's apparently 10 strength, but 1 charisma. He just likes punching things. He doesn't necessarily do the talking part of that. Alright, screw it. We're keeping it boring at this point here, and we're just going for a rifleman. And we'll also take some more agility, because that would be useful. Alright, so here's the deal here. We need to start making our way out east here and take 10 pounds bluff. I mean, help 10 pounds bluff. Get up there and see what they're saying. Then we expand. And another thing about that poll, by the way, like, a staggeringly low amount of you gave a shit about Sean or Nora. Like, you guys didn't give a fuck about them. You just wanted me to murder everyone. So that's what I'm gonna do. I mean, if you ask McGraw, then he'd probably tell you that murder is the best policy as well. Yeah, we need to stay careful around these parts, though. Ooh, Bloodleaf, yeah. Alright, there's gonna be those mole rats that have got mines on their back. They're gonna be working around this place somewhere. I've only got myself 31 bullets for this 10mm pistol I've got here. So we need to try and be very, very quiet. Very, very subtle. Until the moment's right, and then we just destroy everything. Because that's what always happens, is we destroy everything. Oh shit, we got a couple of raiders right here. They don't even know. Right, this is what I'm gonna do.
No.
You, dog me. Dog, just... I want you... no, sorry.
Never mind, boy.
Sorry, you looked at me there so with such sad eyes.
Hey.
Yeah, dog meat.
Wait there.
Right, you just simmered in for 2 minutes, right? I'm gonna go and deal with this shit. I'll be back in a second. Right, we got a raider there. Make it one to his right. Let me try and get myself in there nice and close. Where are they? Right. They're just hanging out. Pretty sure this may be where the mole rats are as well, though. Nope, it's just the two of them. It's just the two of them. There's a couple of different options I could go for here. 95 shots with the laser musket. That might be worth actually using. Good thing Preston handed me this. Oh, they've got a dog as well. Shit. See, the other guy's asleep. This guy is awake. This is the one we should go for. And I missed. And I fucking missed. And I missed again, I don't understand. What? Oh shit, that's a grenade, that is... Okay. I can't believe I just died instantly and those two shots just didn't work at all. Now I need to talk to this ballbag again.
Sturgis.
You willing to do some work?
Are you willing to do some work? That's more like the fucking question here.
For starters, we could use some real beds.
Well, too bad. No. Right. Attempt number two. Let's get fucking out there and let's get this sorted. See these guys here this time round. There they are. See, I've already circumvented them, but I don't want to have to deal with them on my way back. So, this time, what I'm going to do is... Bum rush, you bastards, get in there. Come on, go, 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 go. Get it in there. Yay! Fear my wrath. Oh shit, oh there's another one. Okay, dog, there we go. Hold him nice and still. I'll just execute the bastard right now. See, that worked. That was actually worked a bit too well, to be honest with you. Some of you are probably very confused, because there's one thing I never told you about old Wamba McGraw here. He's a dragonborn as well, you know. See? Ooh. Okay, that might have been a bit more powerful than I was expecting it to be, man. I mean, everyone just exploded. Yeah, Dogmeat looks way more badass now, man. We've got him kitted out with the best of gear. Dogmeat.
Hey.
Dogmeat. Jesus fucking Christ, man. Can you just stop for 1 second? Look at him. Yeah, he looks so cool. Psycho. Mole rat chunks that are just lying on the floor. Yeah, I'll eat that. Don't worry about that. Need to get myself some proper armor, man. I'm just getting absolutely torn to shreds. What have you got? You got a chest piece? Leather chest piece. Yeah, just a little bit more protection. Oh, we have trouble afoot just here. Oh shit, I think this may be the mole rat territory with the suicide bombing mole rats. McGraw's one ball is tingly. That's like his spidey sense. Anytime you get a wee tingle on that ball, that's when you know there's some shit about to go down. Oh, see? See, you can sense it. What's going on out there? Oh, they're the mole rats. The mole rats are attacking their owners, or there's bloatflies or something happening up there. There's been a mutiny among the mole rats. Let's get this musket charged up. Oh shit. Oh, there he is. He's onto me. And he's dead. Alright. Good shit. Now we've got dogs or something on their way. Let's see what it is. What are you doing over here, dog? You want to have a go, eh? Do you think you're hard enough, son? Do you think you're hard enough? You're no hard enough, pal. You want to have a go, mate? You want to have a go? Hey! And again. Shit. And my dog. Oh, my dog is way more powerful than that dog. Get a reload in there. Finish the fucker off. Come on, McGraw. Shoot! He's hesitating. He doesn't like killing dogs. But this one has to go down because it was about to eat my dog and we can't be having that shit. Right, collect all the dog meat. I'm gonna have a feast tonight. There's still some more things around here. Rad stag. Attack dog. Oh shit, that fucker looks vicious, man. Look at the eyes, man. Get rid of the bastard. Yeah, I think I might have actually been the last thing in this base, so we can just come into the place and ransack it. Get in over this fence. Or maybe not. Maybe we go around the fence. Yeah, we go around the fence. Since we've claimed... Who stuck a screwdriver in the toaster? Who thought that was a good idea? Let's get a wee nap here. We're halfway to our objective, although there's something still cutting about around here somewhere. Oh, I think we might have our first dungeon, lads. Don't really remember this part of the map that well, so I can't exactly remember what's in here, but we're gonna go in and have a wee swatch. If anything tries to get in our way, we're gonna fuck it up. Right, so what's happening in this place then? Okay, we get lasers. Oh wait, I think I remember this place. Is there not a sentry bot or some shit in here? Yeah, this place rings a bell, definitely. There might be some raiders and stuff. Maybe some gas. We have a screwdriver. Oh shit, there's one. There's one right there. Okay. We're gonna interaction mode in a second. Where is he? Come on, mate. Show yourself. Where the fuck did he go?
Who's there?
Oh, shit. Shit, too far away for the shotgun. Right, come on. Yep, nothing there now. Oh, he's dead. Right, okay. Enter action mode. There he is. Getting close, close the distance. Oh shit, no, don't close the distance. There's like four of them over there. Come on then. Cool, cute. Oh, I just reloaded. What happened to my reload? Yeah, you're dead now, son. Oh shit, that's not good. That is not good. Okay. We can fix this. We can fix this shit. Okay, running.
I'm just getting started.
Okay, this is bad. The dog is dying. We have a minigun on the loose around here somewhere, I think. There's a guy. Oh wait, no, he's not even the last one. Oh wait, he might be the last one up here. Come on, kill him. Ah, shit, there's like two of them there. Get fucking up, dog. Come on. We need you in this fucking fight.
You're tough. Come on.
Think I'm tough. I'm the fucking toughest hen. You have no idea. I've mothered entire villages. Yeah. Right. Go, dog meat, go. Oh, there you are. Hey! You do not mess with he who has one ball. Right, so what's going on in this place? We get system errors all over the shop. Nothing seems to be working. That's the Fallout way. Was there anything actually worth coming into this place for? Because it just seems like there's just a few random raiders with some basic stuff on them, which is not bad. I mean, at this stage in the game, you kind of need your basic stuff. You need to just build up your sort of base level, like, equipment and guns and stuff like that, just to try and take on the threats the wasteland throws at you. Ooh, some medics. You never use it, but you always pick it up. Alright. So this guy was the one with a minigun. This woman here. You fucking shot my dog, you bastard. And yet again, we have another minigun. I could take the minigun. I do have plenty of room for the minigun. I'm gonna take the minigun. There's no way I'm not taking that. Wait, where did I just... Where did I just find? What was that? I missed that there because I clicked the button too fast because I wasn't expecting it to do that there. Locket. It was the locket, right? Yeah, so found a locket in here for some reason. Oh. Not fucking with any of that shit. Oversized fucking cockroaches all over a gaff. Can't be having that in a world that's gonna be dominated by McGraw. A world like that has no cockroaches. Nope. Oh, I don't want radiation over that. Aha! See ya, wee bastard, trying to scare me. That's no happening, son. Intel room key. Okay, apparently there's an intel room. I didn't see it so far, so we'll see if we can find it. Oh, look at a little teddy bear, man. I always love the little random teddy bears they put about the bloody map. With shit like this. I mean, I got an army helmet from it. That's probably useful, to be honest. Also, so is the level up that I got. Now, let's start getting sneak going up a little bit here, man. We need to get that light step perk. The next level up of sneak 2. Where you're not going to be triggering mines and stuff. Because in survival mode, those are so much more annoying than in normal mode. It said there was an intel room somewhere. So where is that? Is that this one? That's the one. Alright. Any more bugs in here waiting for me now? Cigar box, you say. What was that there? Oh, a mini nuke. And a US covert operations manual. I can read the English we're talking about. Permanently more difficult to detect while sneaking. So that's actually, I've just jumped up a couple of. I just jumped, got sneak just there, and then also got that on top of it. So it's not bad. We've managed to pick up quite a bit of sneak ability just coming into this one little base just here. Alright, let's take all the stuff out of the safe. Ransack that safe. Tactical light pipe pistol. Why would I need that? I'm gonna take it. Do you know what? I'm gonna take this other one too, and I'm just gonna take all the parts off of them all, and I'm gonna try and make the ultimate pipe pistol, which will still be shit. Now we've cleared this place out now, let's get the fuck out of here. Get back out into the Commonwealth, into the wasteland, see what kind of trouble we can find. And I just remembered, man, we need to get our combat helmet on. He looks a bit derpy just now, but well, you know what? I can fix this. Now we're properly dressed and ready for war. Either way, off we go. We're gonna find our way back out to Ten Pines Bluff here. Oh shit, there he is! Okay. That's the mole rat that I was talking about. I've been talking about this since the first episode. So what's next on the old agenda then? We can make our way right down to Ten Pines Bluff from here. Shouldn't be anything in our way. But then again, this game is known to just throw shit at you at the least expected moment. Dogs down there. Right. Dogs I can handle. Dogs I could do with. I can do with some more dog meat. Okay, there's one closer to me. There he is. They didn't even hear it. Didn't even hear that one either. Come on, dog. Oh, missed that one. Is he gonna follow it up? Is he gonna look for me? Nope, he's dead. Because apparently the dogs are pretty fucking stupid. Alpha wild mongrel, you say? Go on then. Come on, have a fucking go, son. Ah, I knew you're just a pile of mush. Now we've made it all the way to the settlement that needs our help so desperately. So, where's the proprietor of this establishment right here? Oh, pal. Get fucking up, man. Wambo McGraw's here to save the day.
What do you want? We don't need any more trouble around here.
I'm here to solve the trouble, Hen.
I sent word with one of them passing traitors, but honestly, I never expected anything to come of it. Most people don't put much stock in the Minutemen these days after Quincy. Bad business, that.
I'll tell you it's good business, Hen. Killing cunts. Right, point me in the direction of these guys in and I'll go and fuck them up. Apparently they're all the way down at the Corvega assembly plant. Fantastic. Did you know there's guys with nuke launchers and shit down there? Come on. I show up in the middle of the night and you're like, yeah, go down there where there's about a million raiders. Just you go and solve it. It's fine. Let's use this crafting stick. I'm not allied. Yeah, I'm only just cooking steaks, lads. Come on. Well, is there a bed that I can use before? I can't use those beds. But in the meantime, I can just take all your tatties. Give me all the tatties. So many tatties. I'm taking all the tatties. Right. Now just get the water all pumped up. Get yourself stocked and ready for the journey ahead. I need to find myself a safe point somewhere, because I'm not dying out here just to be sent back like fucking 200 miles. I think there may be gunners over there. I don't think you want to mess with the gunners over there, especially when you're level 6. Because you're probably going to get destroyed. Hello, wild mongrel. Do you have any friends with you around here by any chance? Hello, son. How you doing? Oh, shit, shit. 95. Yeah. Right, let's harvest the mole rat meat from the pile of ashes. Because that makes sense. Now let's see who this guy is. Is this Lucas? Is this the guy with the armor? No, who are you? Trader, just a random trader.
Hi. I'm always open for business.
Just like your ma. Right now, there's not really much that this offers me. Oh, squirrel bits though. I'll have squirrel bits. And antibiotics. Those are really... Oh no, I can't even afford them. Damn it, I want that body. I want the antibiotics. An overdue book. Yeah, I'll take that. Yeah, I'm not able to afford that just now. Oh, is there anything that I can sell you? Investigate the sailing ship. The fuck was that just there? I just remembered there, you sell these, so I get 30 for that, so that's okay. Investigate the Museum of Witchcraft. Where did I just learn that from? She didn't say anything, man. There's something up ahead. Oh, it's ghouls! Our first encounter with ghouls. The wine bowl is ready. 1, 2, 3. I remember this little house. There's about 10 of the fuckers in here. And this guy... Is the trader wandering in this direction still? Are they coming over here? I don't know if they are. Could have used their help potentially, but... Looks like we're gonna have to get close and personal. Oh, it's the train yard. There's shitloads of them around here. Right, okay. Let's get you down, son. I missed. I think I shot under his arm, between his arm and his armpit. Right, okay, come on, mate. Charge at me. I somehow missed that one, I don't know how. There it is. Right, okay. Okay, here we go. Nope, we fucked it up. Right. Out of the way, dog. Nope, 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 nope. You're not giving me a disease. Oh, he's struggling with the hill. Oh, shit. He was struggling with that hill a little bit there. Right, there's something else that knows I'm here, but it's... not close enough yet to be a real problem, is it? I hope. I think it's just these guys over here. Okay. Ah, you can finish him off with this. There you are, son. Uh-oh. This is not good. This is not good at all. Get his legs. Get... Oh, wait. I shot the dog. And the dog just murdered him right away. What the fuck? Okay, dog. Apparently the dog is way more powerful than me. We're gonna change that eventually. We'll shift the balance of power and I will become the most powerful entity in the fucking universe. Don't you worry about that, man. One bomb of Gros' fucking destiny is sealed in blood. Right, okay. There's gonna be more of them in here. Need to try and take it. Take it slow. Okay, that was a complete waste of time. Let's send this. Ooh. Okay. Bayoneted heavy pipe bolt action rifle. See, the problem is I've got a lot of junk on me. I could just store the junk here and then make sure I grab it on the way back, because this is kind of close to Ten Pines Bluff. I need to just remember, Bedford Station, I'm going to be leaving all sorts of random shit. So if I forget, remember to remind me in the comments down below. I'm going to need this minigun and stuff, so I'm just going to drop absolutely every single piece, apart from the pre-war money. You never drop the pre-war money. And drop every single piece of junk. Send this steamer trunk right here at Bedford Station. I'm going to pick up the cola bottles because that is actually useful. Oh shit, Jesus fucking Christ, man. Oh, I thought I'd already cleared this place out. Ah, no, 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 no. Okay, dog's gone. Wait, I just reloaded, man. Oh, hello, you still alive? We got another one up front here. Apparently this... Oh, I need a better sight on this thing, man. I don't like this thing at all. I'm only using this because it's got the most ammo of anything that I've got at the moment. Because, I mean, after it gets a few levels down the line, I'm not going to be using this piece of shit. There's a railway rifle around here somewhere. The fuck just set that off? Did you just open that door, dog? What the fuck? Think I may have murdered everything around here already. Dutchman's instructions. Let's see what Dutchman's instructions were.
Delivered your package to the old switching station. The runner arrives at midnight. If you need gear, look for the blue barrel.
Alright, okay, look for the blue barrel. That's where our famous little railway rifle is going to be hiding. We got a bed in here that I can use. Pipe pistol and a lot of blood. Doesn't look like shit went well. Station master's terminal. Let's see what this wee holotape's got to say.
She's late. No, something's wrong. Someone's coming. Look, 5 of them. It's a trap. Damn it, they've got us surrounded. What do we do?
Apparently get fucked.
I'll draw them off. Give me a count of 10, then break for the tree line. What? Dutchman, I... There's no time. Good luck, A9. 10, 9, 8, 7... No! No! No, I'm not going back. I can't. I won't.
I must be what this is. He must have shot himself. He must have just been like, nah, fuck that shit, and just shot himself in the fuck. Yeah, that's what it kind of looks like. With the blood splatter on the wall and the gun on the floor, that kind of looks like that's probably what happened there. So that didn't exactly go well. So what did he? What was the plan here? Is he sitting here? He was just sitting on his wee chair, and he let Dutchman sprint out, sprint down here, instantly get gunned down. It said break for the tree line, so I don't where. What tree line do you think that guy was going to run to? This one, like. Where were they? Were they over here? Did they just shoot him from here? And his plan was he was gonna run out here and run fucking somewhere, and he was supposed to run out and run away. But that doesn't seem like a very good plan, to be totally honest. That's probably why it resulted in this. Too bad for you, Dutchman. Now, I found a bed, so I'm probably just going to drop a save. But for people that don't know, this is survival mode, and you need to be sleeping constantly, right? My guy's tired at the moment, and I found this sleeping bag just here. The problem with the sleeping bag is you can only sleep in a sleeping bag for 3 hours, so it doesn't replenish. Dog, can you simmer the fuck down? It doesn't replenish your sleep. It just saves. So you don't want to sleep for 3 hours because it doesn't do anything to your like sleep deprivation that's going on. In fact, it makes it worse. So you only want to get 1 hour of sleep and try and find fucking Jesus Christ, dog, could you simmer the fuck down? But yeah, you want to sleep for 1 hour when you're only dropping a save, and try and find a proper bed. If you find a proper bed, you can sleep for 24 hours if you want. But now it's just time to eat some dogs. I hope you don't object to that, dog meat. Ah, Brahmin. Some random Brahmin. I could go a few steaks. I hope they don't fight back, because they could probably kill me. Sorry, Brahmin. Sorry about this. I feel really bad about doing this to you, but it's just... Sorry, man. We got 2 out of 3. Apparently the third Brahmin got the fuck out of there as soon as the bullets started flying. Right, I'm needing to clear out this place. So I might as well just do that while I'm here. And then that way we can start building our kingdom with our first very own proper outpost. Where's the fucking ghouls? Plus there's a bottle cap mine right there, and I'm no falling for this shite, because apparently I did that one time before. So just get at the fuck. I'm not getting blown up by any fucking random stray mines, I hope. He's about to try and bite my dog in the ass. We can't be having that. Oh. Oh, shit. Alright, cool. Well, his head just fucking exploded. There it is. See that mine right there? First time I played survival mode, I was out for about an hour without saving, and I did all sorts of shit. And then as soon as I wandered around this place, I walked right into that fucking mine, because you can't see it because you walk up the stairs and it's right in front of you. Right. Moving on this side here. This is when we come up against. I think there might even be a legendary in here. Is it not rad roaches, from what I remember? Yes. Come on, you wee bastards, I know you're in here. I know you're in here. There it is! And we found ourselves a Nuka-Cola Quantum. All in a day's work. Oh, expert walk, so I can't even get into that. Fantastic. Oh well, we found a fusion core which is going to send us overweight instantly. Fantastic. Let me just take as much stuff as I possibly can. Dog? Seriously? Gonna move? All I need to do is transport it right over here. Before it hurts me. Carrying too much. I know, man. I cleared this place. Can I do this? Yeah, store all the junk. There it is. Right into that. I think I need to go over to the workbench first before I'm allowed to move that around. But I think our first ever little outpost has been claimed. We're going to turn the... Feast your eyes on it just now, right? This is going to get turned into one of the biggest fucking battle fortresses of the wasteland. First order of business for this place. Get rid of all these bloody radioactive barrels in the middle of my fucking... base. I just took like a shitload of rad damage there. And just to break in this new place, let's just get ourselves a nice wee night's sleep. Yeah. Ah shit, we managed to get an illness from taking a fucking sleep. Ah, I don't have any antibiotics yet. That's what that was that I wanted to buy off of the trader earlier on. And apparently we have picked up infection, periodic damage. Shit, that is not good. That is really not good. I'm really close to the Corvega plant, but there's probably antibiotics in there somewhere because it is a pretty major big spot with a lot of people in it. But taking that damage while down there and trying to fight on the radar, take on all the raiders and do all that shit, it's not gonna be easy. Oh, fuck. Just fucked around with a couple of guns just there. Just for future reference, by the way, this gun shall now be referred to as the Barrels of Justice. And this 44 Magnum is now just called...
See?
Okay, so this is where we need to be careful, because there's quite a few raiders dotted around up ahead. There. That's it. That guy right there has a nuke launcher. So you don't want to fuck with him. I mean... fuck. Right, I think it's time to get a stim pack in there. Get some hydration going. I think we should probably take a shot at him and then run. Right, you don't want to be standing around there. You don't... Oh, that was just trolley stab. Okay. This guy is notorious in this game. This guy, everyone knows about this guy. If you've played this game, you should know about this guy already. Because this fucking guy is usually the first guy that will kill you in the game. Shit, I missed him. You don't want to get too close because he will end you in one shot. So we need to try and whittle him down a little bit, shot by shot here with the musket from distance. I think I killed someone else. Yep, you can still see his light on his power armor. This guy wears power armor and has a mini nuke launcher, so... Or a fat man, rather. But yeah, he's up there. Oh, see, there he is. I missed him again. Shit. Okay. I really need a scope or something for this gun. Okay, we got him with a sneak attack. If I fire again too quickly though, he is going to fucking fire a blind fire shot over here. Which wouldn't be the worst thing ever, but at the same time, we don't want him accidentally hitting me with the fucking thing. I just don't know how much health he has left either. Okay, I'm gonna move around this side. You approach from the right hand side, he doesn't have a line of sight on you until you're really close to him. But then again, he might just hit you with a nuke given you're really close to him. He'll kill himself, but he's stupid and doesn't give a fuck. Okay, so I need to try and... Oh shit, they're fucking zombies. Zombies! Dog meat! Try that! Get him! Fucking get him! Wait, never mind then. What the hell, man? I swear half of those shots just there just went right through him. That was kind of weird. Right, I'm gonna search this house right here. Because we need to get rid of these zombies because they're gonna give me away when the real fight comes. So yeah, this place is infested with ghouls. Right, we've triggered them all and now it's time to get the fuck out of here. Come on, go. Okay, come on. Make your way down here. Come on, mate, yeah. Die! Right. Another one down. Really, man? The dog get... Oh, wait, there's two of them. Right. There's three. That's probably why. Ah, shit. Right, okay. I have such bad weapons right now. Come on, mate. There we go. And he's down. Although something else is on to me. Get a good old leg. Oh well, the legs aren't really that exposed somehow, so let me just make sure I kill you. One more. Okay, my infection is almost killing me at this point. I'm gonna have to start building this charisma, man. If I'm gonna be taking over a wasteland, charisma needs to start going up. So let's just take that in the meantime, right? Okay, I really need to just sort out this bloody infection. It's gonna end up killing me here. Oh yeah, my dog, I forgot about you, son. How you doing? Let me just stick you in the head with a big needle. It's fine. Hey, I need to sort this guy out, man. I swear to God, if he kills me, I'm gonna be pretty angry, pretty upset. There's guys up there to my right, but you don't want to fuck with them until you deal with this guy. Where is he? I don't know if I've went past the bridge yet or if it's just coming up. It might just be here. Yep, there it is. There it is right there. Uh-oh, that's bad. You really don't want to be spotted instantly, right? What's my highest DPS weapon? What is the weapon that I will get the most out of in one shot? So, I get 37 from that. 60 from the pistol. I only have two shots for her though, but that is 120 damage just right away without having to get too close to the guy. Right. Gonna have to try and take him down with... Yeah, see? The fuck is doing that? I don't like this. Ah, there he is. There he is. Ah, see? Oh, don't you, I swear to God, if I die to a random ghoul. Why am I reloading? I thought I already reloaded this. Ah, shit. No. It hit me one time. It's fired like 100 bullets at me. It hit me one time and I almost died. Okay. Can you stop firing for 1 second? What? Okay, you can't hit me from here. Thankfully. Just hoping that nothing else comes up and kills me. Managed to just about win in this area, but there's something killed my dog. Okay, it's ghouls. Ghouls. Fuck. How did you still hit me? Fuck you, man. Oh, there's more. Fucking infection. The gonorrhea is spreading. I'm gonna run out of water and stim packs at this rate, man. Trying to keep myself alive. There's more. I need more shotgun shells as well. I've wasted like all of them. There. It's not all of them, unfortunately. Doc, what were you even doing over here? Is this one dead? Hey, at least I've got the starting point of I killed the guy with the nuke launcher, so I want to at least see if I can drop a 1 hour save. Oh, fuck. Jesus, man, I don't like this place at all. If I can get a 1 hour save, that's me. I'd be saved. I'd be done. I'd be sorted. Apparently, there's every fucking ghoul in the game is coming after me right now. Here it comes. And now they're... fucking raiders from the factory are gonna come down here. I'm not ready for them yet. Right now I'm just trying to deal with the infection. I'm gonna run out of stim packs very soon if I don't find a doctor. It's worth noting, by the way, that actually in that sky, oh, there's the bloody thing right there. Right, Mini Newt and the fat man get an hour of sleep, and I lost some health from doing that. I'm gonna have to use my quantum that I found already. Where is it? Well, it's worth noting, by the way, with the Dragonborn Shout, Dragon Shout mod that I've got here, I do have teleport. I don't know how that works, but it's there. I'm way overweight at this point here, so I might need to just drop the minigun. There's no reason to be carrying the minigun. I have a fat man now, so that's as much big guns as I'm really gonna need. So, let me just drop all this shit right here. I'm gonna use the mini nuke on the front of that building over there, but I'm gonna... Oh. If I get somewhere I can leave it just now? Apparently I don't, right. I forgot to pick up that railway rifle as I went past the place. I'll get that on the way back. Okay, I've dropped all of the heavy shit for now. So I need to try and find some bloody antibiotics, and I know they're all there. I just need to find the antibiotics. I got myself my pipe rifle. And quite a good wee vantage point, man. Private Jackson would be proud of this vantage spot. Yeah, that is his name. It's Private Jackson, right? What do I need for antibiotics? I need Chemist 1 and I need Golden Fungus and Acid. We need to be dropping some acid in there. So apparently I can't just make my own in the meantime. Plus I'm pretty sure you would need like a really high intelligence level before you can even get- Oh shit! Oh, why? Why have I run out of ammo right now? Shoot him. Right in the chest. Right, okay. Is my shotgun reloaded? Can I use it? Because apparently I keep switching to it and it's not- Whoa, shit. I keep switching to it and it's fucking empty. I don't know why that is, right? It's reloaded. So, it's reloaded. So, don't be a dick next time, shotgun, please. Climbing the stairs, thinking I'm up there. Come on, mate, you just get hit with a dose of the barrels of justice. Or the Super Duper Mart. There's gotta be some fucking antibiotics inside the Super Duper Mart. There's got to be. It's not an exact science or anything, but I think there's probably gotta be some antibiotics in the Super Duper Mart. There's a shitload of zombies in here. Right, you know what? Before we start this shitstorm, I'm gonna make sure every gun I have is loaded and set to be used in a hotkey, because too often I keep finding myself trying to juggle around guns that are empty. Right, we're going to be using this 10mm mainly in here. Apparently a ton of them are already dead. I'm a little bit suspicious about this. Right, you know what you actually do? No sneaking around and getting jump scared, right? We just fucking... Come on, guys! Nah? No takers? No one. No one's wanting to have a go just yet.
Loctite.
Fuck. Let's have a look at this. This might actually provide me with something. Okay, I know what I'm doing, game. And it's live or live. I don't know. The English language is weird. Disengaged lock to that safe. Oh, nice. Get the Protectron out there. I'm hoping that's a friendly Protectron. It won't bother with me. If it just patrols around the place and fucks up ghouls, then I'll be happy with that. But if it tries to shoot me, then I won't be happy with that, because that's a pretty tough fucking Protectron. At this stage of the game just here, you want to try and get as much help as you possibly can. Oh, pre-war money. I'm confused as to where all the ghouls are, because I know you get flooded with ghouls in this place. Why are they all dead already? Nope! Okay. Okay. Minor scare. Just a minor scare. I think it's time for that quantum. Let's just get a quantum in there. Sounds like the Protectron's found a couple of ghouls just hiding somewhere. Right, no, Doc, I don't have time. I don't have fucking time for this. Come on, out of the way. Any more of you? I need to start looking on these shelves. So this looks like the wine section, the alcohol section. I'm hoping you don't object to me just taking stuff off the shelves, because that's kind of what it's programmed to prevent in this place. What have we got? Bottle caps. Pork and beans and that. So that's... Is this... Dirty water. Fuck. Fancy lads. Snack cakes. That's not what I'm after. We need some drugs, lads. Is there any drugs around this place? No, this door I'll be in. Come on. Oh shit. Hey, we're in. There's gonna be more of them though coming out of this, but let's get this reloaded. Come on. Where are yous? Where are yous hiding? Right, there's gonna be a bunch of them coming from up there, so since I have a few of these... Yeah! Nice and crispy. Oh! Son, you need to stay crispy. Something is after me. I'm hoping it's not the Protectron, because he looked like he was gonna take quite a few bullets to kill.
Yes.
Buff out in Radex. Fuck's sake, come on! Oh, Protectron's found something. He can deal with that, it's fine. Oh, Josh's holotape. Go- Oh, hunting rifle! That'll come in handy. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what's going on out there, but, Protectron's doing some work. Oh, shit, I've just realised my health's about to go. Stimpak. Man, I didn't even realise just how bad it was there. Oh, man, I need this antibiotics. That trader, I should have bought it off that trader. I should have cleared out all my money and just bought it. Just bit the bullet and just bought it.
Out of my way. One bomb McGraw doesn't have any time for your shite. Oh, fuck. Taking more damage. Ah, it's just a race against time now, man. Do you know, I've never, in all the time that I played survival mode on my first original survival mode save, mate, no time for your shite, okay? In all my time of playing survival mode on my normal sort of playthrough, I never, ever, ever got stuck in this position where I was desperate for antibiotics and dying of some sort of infection. What is going on out there? Gotta be honest, the Protectron's turned out to be a really good fucking idea. Fusion core. I swear to God, there should be some fucking... Usually you have like a medicine section and stuff inside a shop. Like, where's all the medicine at? Saying that, it could be where this fell down. I don't know. I swear I found antibiotics in here the first time round. See, it doesn't help that the one place where I actually did find some was where there was, it was a trader that was moving around. I knew I saw something there. Oh, hello. No, the infection's doing more damage to me than the bloody ghouls are. Whoa, shit, dog, man, calm yourself. Okay, you know what? I might just need to find myself a fucking doctor. You've served your purpose well. Thank you so much. And I got full health from doing that. That was actually totally worth it. I'm gonna need to try and get some sort of... So where's Chemist? Chemist is away down here somewhere. Yep, Chemist is miles down and I've not got anywhere near that level of intelligence, so I can't get that. So fucking fantastic. Okay, we're taking sneak 2, so I don't need to worry about mines anymore. Like, it's a good idea just to get that as early as you can, because mines can end you instantly if you're not paying attention. I need bottles to get some more water going, man. Buff out. Ah, shit, this must be the drug section just here, and there's no fucking antibiotics on it. Oh, wait. Employees only. This might be it. This might be the one. This might be the room. I saw some shit on the table just there. No! Okay. Right, there's gonna be some zombies back here. Drugs. Okay, Rad-X. Ah, shh. Oh shit, the dog just dragged him down there. oh shit. Oh, right, okay then. Antibiotics? No. No. Come on. Ah, I think I'm better off using the lifeline that I got from that level up. And I know Diamond City's down there, but I would need to battle my way through so much shit before I even get there that I don't even think I would be able to make it. So I might need to... Where can I even go? I don't know where any doctors are yet. I don't know where any doctors are, where any shops are that I can use to buy antibiotics. I could probably head all the way back up and go to this... there's a Red Rocket... station somewhere over here. So I think I'm probably better off just going up this way and seeing if I can find it, because there's, I can't see anything in here. I'm sure there's probably something in here somewhere. Some antibiotics just chilling somewhere. Oh, quantums, I'll have those. But I think I'm gonna have to just not go in and... Oh, it's Psycho. I've found every other kind of drug, but I've not found the one thing that I'm desperately lacking. Ah, man, I just just got hurt instantly there. Right, okay, yeah, we need to head up towards that marker. There's a trader up that way, and maybe, just maybe, she might have what I need. But I can't really afford to be wasting any more time digging through the place around here, trying my best to find something. I've already been through that Red Rocket station, so... back up this way. Just retreat. Retreat right now, because the gonorrhea is very, very vicious and it's going to kill me. Okay. See, this is kind of the stage in the game where everywhere has people that will murder you instantly if you're not careful. Especially on survival mode. Ah, I see a quantum over there. We had a deal, Drew. Hey, you guys hold on. I'm doing something here first. It's end something happening over here, lads. Whoa, easy there. Hey, whoa. Yep. I'm now heading. No, I'm not. Can you just hold on, guys? Don't look at me. I'm just back here. Doing nothing of your concern.
Come on. Come on, kill him. Kill him. Kill him. I missed every shot. And he's dead. He's now being crispified. Okay. Now, I could have spoke to them, but I wanted to try and get the sneak attack in on them and wipe them out that way. But yeah, they were causing problems for this woman. And this woman now just goes back to her day. She doesn't seem to be bothering too much about the fact I just murdered those two guys.
Here, this is for you. Now, if you ever need to trade, my shop's open.
Yeah, 100 bottle caps, I'll do. Yeah, okay. Right, please. Please. She doesn't have any fucking... Oh, Jesus. Okay, well, I'm gonna have to buy some water and some... See, I don't want to get dirty water, because if you drink dirty water, it is cheaper, but you get rads and you can get more infections. That doesn't help anyone, does it? But you know what? We're just gonna sell the minigun. The minigun is useless to me at this point. In fact, did I not drop the minigun? What was that I just sold there? Oh, apparently I was carrying around all that ammo for like no reason, because I already dropped the minigun. Nope, don't cancel the trade in progress, right? Okay, we made some money off of her at least, but we haven't gotten ourselves any fucking antibiotics. Like, even if I found some here, I would actually kill the woman just to get the fucking antibiotics at this stage. Even though I wouldn't normally do that, because it's just destroying a trader for like no reason, but antibiotics is a perfectly good fucking reason. Right, no, nothing of interest here, and nothing of interest here. Shit. I'm just retracing my steps all the way up to Concord and fucking the Museum of Freedom and stuff up here. Oh my god, it's taking so much of my health. Okay, trash can Carla, do you have any antibiotics? Please. Just threaten. Hold on, I'll do that in a second. Do that in 1 second. Addictol is not lying. Antibiotics! Yes! Okay. Okay, we might. In fact, you know what? I'm not gonna threaten this woman. This woman has just saved me. And as a thank you to that, I'm gonna sell. Should I even sell a couple of those? I mean, I'm really not making that much money off of anything. That's probably because my really low charisma. That's probably what that probably is. Alright, either way, I'm happy to just spend that money. Thank you. We finally got a hold of some fucking antibiotics, so I'm no longer gonna just die from dying out in the fucking wilderness here. Time to retreat to the home base, because I'm low on ammo, I'm low on everything I need to save, and just, in general, I just need to just return to the home base and come back here tomorrow to make sure we can solve this fucking problem for 10 pounds bluff once and for all. I'm gonna take this with me, yeah. Ah, apparently this guy's just regen stuff. What are you shouting about, Doug? What? What are you barking at? Where are you off to? Oh yeah, okay, yeah, I forgot about this. Yeah, someone else was talking about that in the fucking comments last week. Duffel bag just here. I did forget about that, I genuinely did. But, you know, we got it now, we got some Molotovs, I've got myself some frag grenades, and we're stocked and ready to go on our next adventure. But in the meantime, we're just gonna rest in the comfort of our home base of Sack Mountain. Alright, saved, well rest. Ah, fucking Jesus Christ. Mama Murphy's just been standing staring at me for like 5 minutes. Alright, we're all set and ready to go. Get out there and tackle this wasteland. Now, I've got the one problem that I took a fair amount of rad damage just over the course of that little adventure just there. So, I need to try and find myself a doctor or something, because I don't think... Hold on, before I go anywhere. A decontamination arch is gonna take me one more bit of aluminium and 6 fiber optics. What? There's fucking rad roaches still here? The fuck? But yeah, no, there's just some materials that are just a little bit more difficult to come across around here. And fiber optics is kind of one of them, unfortunately. So, one of the things that I'm actually gonna need to do further down the line is I'm gonna wanna take Gun Nut and I'm wanna take Scrapper. So I need to take another 2 levels of intelligence before I get there. So I need to unlock that. If I wanna be getting a lot more materials out of guns that I'm picking up, then you can just run around scrapping all sorts of guns and getting all sorts of different materials very, very easily. Honestly, anyone playing survival mode out there, if you're doing base building and stuff, then Scrapper is so useful. But we'll get to that further down the line. In the meantime just now, I need to finish off this little quest here and I need to make my way back down to the Corvega factory, and we're gonna boss the place, and everything's gonna be fucking brilliant, and everyone's gonna love us and all that good shit. That's the plan, and we're gonna just go and execute that shit right now. Alright, come on, dog. Get that nose up and sniff out the enemy. Don't worry, they smell like shite, so it should be quite easy to find them. Yeah, what's this fire that's going on down here? Here, lads. He's having a wee dinner down here. Hey, what's happening? Where's that light coming from? It's just a random fire that's just burning away for literally no reason. I'm just gonna come over and knock your milk bottles, pal. Hey, so this time when we're tackling the Corvega factory, we can actually get in there without dying a very slow and painful death due to diseases that were picked up from shitty mattresses. Yeah, my way. Oh shit. There you are. There's another one. There it is. Oh, there was like one pixel for me to actually shoot there. That was a decent shot. What have we got? Oh, well that works fucking fantastically. Okay, so there's a factory right there. I'm gonna investigate this house.
Look, man, I've been thinking about this for a long, long time.
Who the fuck is this?
I know what I'm talking about here.
Bullshit. You can't just put something between two pieces of bread and claim it's a sandwich. Does that mean a loaf of bread is technically a bread sandwich?
Technically, yes, but you wouldn't eat it all at once like that, so it doesn't matter. How you hold it matters.
Talk all you want, man. You put that piece of my lurk meat between two pieces of bread, but it still ain't a sandwich.
Well, what the hell would you call it then?
Disgusting. That's what.
That's your real important conversations you find out here in the wasteland. Just because it's a shitey sandwich doesn't mean that it's not a sandwich, though. I mean, you could quite literally have a shit sandwich. Like, it's still a sandwich. It's fucking rank, though. I wouldn't recommend it. Who put a bread box in the suitcase? Who's... why? Now, some of you are probably wondering, if you've not played Survival Mode as well, why have I not just taken Radaway to get rid of my rats? Because that's quite literally what Radaway is for. Getting rid of rats. Well, in Survival Mode, if you use Radaway, you get all sorts of massive drawbacks. It makes you more susceptible to getting illnesses and getting sick again. Like I was earlier on that you saw in the mad scramble to try and get antibiotics. I would have to go and look for antibiotics again. There's a load of different diseases in Survival Mode, and the one that you saw me get, I think, is the worst one. And the infection one can just straight up kill you. Most of them, you have a slight negative thing, like maybe your intelligence goes down or whatever. They'll have like slight drawbacks, so you want to get it sorted, but they won't kill you. Whereas the one you saw me get was the one that would kill me. There is a Nuka-Cola Quantum up there. That looks a bit too central and sitting it right out in the open to not be a trap. This is totally a trap I'm walking into right now. Radroach. Oh, the Radroach set a really big trap for me. Watch this, it'll be like a fucking super mutant behemoth will come after me or some shit. Well, there you are. The fuck out of my way. Legendary Radroach. The Radroaches are organized. Get him. Come on, this is our first legendary enemy so far. Yeah, right, okay. Kill that wee prick. Is there still more? They truly are coordinated. Where the fuck is the legendary? Where is it? Ghoul Slayer's Raider Right Arm. I mean, it is better than what I already have, but it's not good at all. Ghoul Slayer's Leather Right Arm. That's disappointing, because I was really hoping I would get myself a nice weapon, but no. Right, I want this quantum though. There it is. Yeah. Ah! What the fuck? Go, kill him. Kill him, Dogby. Go. Yeah. Here's where I return to my little stash that I made earlier on. In fact, you know what? I'm not having that. I'm not using that fucking weapon anymore. I'm gonna be using Boom Headshot, and that's gonna be our number one weapon that we use probably most of the time. What are we dealing with here? So we've got one guy just chilling up there, and a couple of sentries and stuff like that. Okay, Your standard stuff, just sort of dotted around the front entrance. And where I could just try and take them out with a sniper rifle from over here, it's entirely possible. Instead, what I'm gonna do is go back to the wee stash that I made earlier on in this building. Because I know this building's safe now. Because I already murdered everything in this building. Oh, it's over there. Okay, sorry. I'm in the wrong fucking building completely. Right, smoldering ash pile. That would be me that did that. Psycho and some herbal tea or whatever the fuck. Peckish from a lack of food. That's fine. I can deal with that. That's totally okay. Eat another couple of dogs and I'm set. Right. So, we got a fat man in here and we've got a bunch of other stuff. I need a container to store my shit in. So, oh, right. There's a thing right here. Yeah. Imagine that had antibiotics in it. I would be so raging if I came back here and it was just sitting there the whole fucking time. Okay. Now we get two shots and plus there's another two of them sitting back there. So we got you sitting on the front door and then you sitting in there and then a whole bunch of you just sort of dotted around the place. Many can I see? Oh, there's three of them over there. I can't really even use a critical. I don't know how to aim these. Right, let's try this. They potentially might have all just died. Okay, at least one of them just died. Kind of disappointing, actually, I've got to be honest. Let's try again with a side. Oh shit, they just got wiped out, man. Okay, let me just back up. Just back up, let them calm down a little bit. And then just sort themselves out. And, you know, they'll be really confused as to what the fuck just happened. But it's fine. It is fine. I got another two ready and waiting. This is a weapon that I really haven't made much use of in the past. Something else just exploded there, a massive nuke explosion. Right, radar scum up top. There's one there. That's the only guys I can see. Is there another guy who has raid there? No, that was just a random thing. Right, okay. Probably about here. Hey, there's another one now. Let's get one thing straight here, right? There's probably like a super tough enemy that's gonna come up in a minute, but I'm not gonna walk around with a fat man. Fat man takes up too much space in your inventory, so I'm happy to just pick one up, fire a nuke or two, and then drop it and continue. I mean, I could keep a hold of it and then sell it. That's probably the smart thing to do with it. But in the meantime, it's just about killing these raiders. Alright, there's one. See, there's been nukes going off and this guy decides, yeah, I'm just gonna go back to staring off at the place. And it missed somehow. That was right on him, but apparently he's too far away. Fallout can be really weird with its hit detection sometimes. Well, he's dead. Oh, hello, mate. There you go. That's the good thing about this Corvega factory thing just here. Is that it's nice and out in the open, so you have plenty of vantage points where you can just pick off raiders and there's not very much they can do in return. I mean, this guy has no idea. I mean, he really should put it together that he's about to be shot because everyone else got shot already, but apparently he didn't know that already. Oh, we got a bed here. A proper bed. I didn't know that was up here. And a cooking station. Ah, just gets better and better. So I don't need to fuck with going all the way back to my home base, back to the Sack Mountain or whatever the fuck I called it. Apparently I'm now carrying too much. Alright then, so I guess we'll just have some Gwinnett Stout just to keep myself going. Well, now we can see. Oh, hello. Nice and dead. Right, once I'm inside, if I can find a nice cluster of them, then they're all gonna get fucked. Yeah, well, let's get this shitstorm underway. Should I go in the front door or should I climb up the stairs? That is the question. Because I know there's other ways you can get into this place. That might be much better than walking right in the front door. Whoa! Hey! Oh, fuck! Jesus, man, you need to stop with those Molotovs! Oh, fucking! I swear to God, I am going to murder everyone. Fucking cow, man. Almost killed me with bastard Molotovs again. That is gonna, like, if you ever play survival mode, that will be your one major enemy, is Molotovs. Not even grenades. It's Molotovs are the one that are the worst, because they just explode instantly and they chuck them at you without warning. So you'll just find sometimes you'll just get clattered right over the head with a fucking bottle and you'll just instantly die. Well, let's just get inside here, because they're just going to start hauling Molotovs at me from fucking every ledge imaginable out front of this place. It says caution. So I need to be wary of a few guys cutting about around here. Ah! Ah, there it is! Okay. This is what's happening, right? It seems like there's a whole bunch of them down there in front of me. So, what's happening is this. Something died over there. I don't know what it was, but it's dead. Oh! Oh wait, I just activated slow-mo by accident. So I forgot the Dragon Shouts thing is attached to Alt, so it's the same button, so we get a nice slow-mo of that there. We can get some nice slow-mo going anytime we want. Where the fuck is... Fuck off. There you are. Murder. Murder now. Fuck you, more like. Anybody else? I mean, it says I'm still in danger, but I've got no idea where from. Oh, I can get up there. Right, okay. Well, hey. Right, let's get a couple of shots in on him, just build up the critical meter. Oh, apparently didn't work. Well, he's dead now. Well. Oh, fucking Jesus. Oh, that's bad. That was a lot of people that just showed up right there. Yeah, you don't want to mess with that many people at the same fucking time. This is probably time for stim packs and water. Okay, hydrated and jet and more water. Right, okay. Yeah, let's fucking do this shit. Come on, get that down there. Okay. Oh, sorry, dog. Sorry, I just punched my dog in the head. I'm still quite low on health, so I don't really wanna mess with them too much at one time. Right, okay. Get the reloads in.
Yo, psst. How you doing, buddy?
Dog's covered in blood, look at his face! Man, this person got crispified. Ah, shit. Reload the fucking gun. There we go. Ah! Oh shit. Killed him right now. Yep, there we go. Okay. Guy just beat my dog to death with a tire iron, what the fuck? Okay, shit. Oh my god, so many guns need reloaded all the fucking time! Okay. There's still more! I need to do more damage with them pistols or something, so yeah, gunslinger. Gunslinger's what we're doing. Right, put my one remaining shotgun shell in the fucking gun. Come on, get up, Doc. Get up. Come on.
No sign of him now. Come on! It's over. You must have run off. Relax.
I'll fucking relax or I'm ready to fucking relax.
This woman's got fucking attitude, man.
You always are such a bad boy.
You're still alive, ain't ya? You should be thanking me instead of bitching all the time. Enough gapping already.
Alright, I think these people might be upstairs. Because I know that there's several levels to this place. I think that's why they all hit me at the same time, is the fact that they all came charging up the stairs. They made a bit of a journey, but, you know, they all got to me at the same time. Dirty water, fuck. Still have one shotgun blast left. Okay, yeah, I know this area. Oh, it's your death, son! Right.
Hey.
Okay. Okay. A guy's still like, oh, what's going on? There's been several gunshots, mate. Come on, you should have worked that out by now. They're above me. I always love it. They're like, you're getting paranoid. There was like gunfire and screams happening a minute ago. And you must have heard the nukes going off and all sorts of shit going on. Guy's like, ah, it's probably fine. This guy's got corn on him. I'll take that. Thank you. Take me to somewhere that I haven't cleared out yet. What's this here? Is this just the door? Leave or... Oh, hello. How you doing? Someone to my right and there's a turret over there. All right. Yeah, there's someone upstairs. Hello, mate. There's still more. Don't know where they are, though. Oh, hello, you got a pool cue! Oh, that's too bad for you, isn't it? Oh, the dog's just gonna take that from you now. Mate. You came to a gunfight with a pool cue, mate. Oh! Zombies! Okay. This is quite a big bit of the map, this right here. Like, the Corvega factory is probably one of the biggest sort of inside dungeons in the whole game, to be honest with you. There's a lot to this place. Ah, shit, what? The fuck? I didn't know that happened. I can't believe I got killed like that there, though. Such a stupid way to die. Like, what the fuck was that? So apparently it's just a little trap that just goes off if you go somewhere anywhere near it. Future reference though, man, back away from shit if it just goes on fire randomly. No, but that's just it. And all the time I've spent in this game, I don't think I've ever seen a trap like that before. Oh, hello. Fuck's sake, I didn't know he was in there.
Guys, stirred up over nothing.
I just shot as he was saying that. Right. Fucking bastard. Oh, well, you're getting munched now. Uh-oh. Right, hold on. The dog's just gonna go on a rampage. I'm too busy trying to work out. Oh, right, okay, so you can shoot that. Hey, dog, back up. I'll deal with this. Oh, there it is, Slow-mo. Oh, blast him in the head. Right in the face. Oh, it's glorious. Oh, shit! Oh, wait, okay, hold on. I've got, like, no health. I'm probably gonna die again if I run around like a fucking idiot like this. Purify water. There we go. Shit. Shooting my dog. Can't be having them shooting my dog. Look at the state of my dog! You fucking dicks! I still have that fat man on me, that mini nuke to launch at them. Come on in, dog. Or just... Oh, never mind.
Going down.
Keep your
what just happened
open.
To my dog?
I think this asshole's using a stealth board.
The fuck?
No sign of him now.
That's what I'm worried about.
Oh shit, I know that this guy over here's a bastard. Right. This must be the guy that I'm gonna use this on. Hold on, have we got a... We got a Jared. That did not work, I didn't even... Oh wait, I nearly killed him. Oh, he's dead now. That was a fucking great idea. Alright, cool, brilliant. Apparently everything's now exploding though. Level up, yeah! That's not good. That is not good. What the fuck is that? Okay! I've never seen that in my life, that thing, before. This is gonna take a bit more preparation. I've been playing for about 3.5 hours now, recording this episode. Alright people, join me next week where Mr. McGraw here is gonna take on the Corvega factory and put it to an end once and for all. Third time lucky, yeah, you know all that shit. It's turned out to be a little bit more difficult than I was anticipating. So, we'll have another go at this next week. I hope you guys have enjoyed. If you have, don't forget to hit the like button down below, and I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.